munaya sarve
yajnatva munaya sarve
param siddhim ito gatah
param siddhim ito gatah knowledge
one way possibly retrieved from material and continuity. It has also been explained that it is due to association with the modes of nature that the living entities entangled in this material world. Now in this chapter, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Supreme Personality explains what those modes of natures are, how they act, how they bind, and how they give duration. The knowledge explained in this chapter is proclaimed by the Supreme Lord to be the superior to the knowledge given so far in other chapters. By understanding this knowledge, various great sages attain perfection and transfer to the spiritual world. The Lord now explains the same knowledge in a better way. This knowledge is far, far superior to all other processes of knowledge, thus far explained. And knowing this, many attain perfection, thus it is expected that one who understands this 14th chapter will attain perfection. Om Ajnana Nirandasya Jnananjanashalakaya Chakshurunmilitam Jainam Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manohishtam Sthapitam Jena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Tadamayam Tadati Svapadamitam Vande Aham Shri Guru Shri Yukta Padakamalam Shri Guru Vaishnavamsya Shri Rupam Sarkaryatam Sahagam Raghunathanitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Sarvabhutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanyadevam Shri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagam Raghunathanitam Sakantamsya Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namami Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Vacharani Nirvishesha Sunyavadi Paschatya Desha Tarini Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namini Gaurati Senam Te Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namaskute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Kadhi Vrindavani Suri Vishabhanam Sute Devi Pancha Kalpataru Vyascha Kalpasindhu Vyavacha Patigyanan Pavanibhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namunama Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityanandara Shri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Shri Bhagavan Vacha Param Bhuya Pravakhyami Jnananam Jnanam Uttamam Yad Jnanpa Anumaya Sarve Param Siddhim Ito Gataha The Supreme Personality of Godhead said, Again, I shall declare to you the Supreme Wisdom, the best of all knowledge, knowing which all the sages have attained the Supreme Perfection. So, there are 18 chapters in this Bhagavad Gita and first 6 chapters dealing with karma, nishkama, karma yoga. Starting from 7th chapter up to 12th chapter, there is a description about pure devotional service, bhakti. But after describing karma and bhakti, niskama karma and bhakti, then Lord is going to explain knowledge, transcendental knowledge. The concluding sixth chapter, starting from 13th chapter to 18th chapter, there is a description of transcendental knowledge. Because bhakti is, as Prabhupada Swami says in Bhakti Rasa Sindhu, bhakti is simply a sentiment without transcendental knowledge. So sometimes you think bhakti has nothing to do with jnana and karma. Bhakti is independent. But here is the knowledge described here is not the ordinary knowledge. This is transcendental knowledge. Knowledge two types. There is material knowledge and spiritual knowledge. Adhyatma vidya and bhautika vidya. And Krishna told adhyatma vidya vidyanam. Krishna represents adhyatma vidya, spiritual knowledge. So this concluding chapters is explaining your transcendental knowledge. By knowing this knowledge, we can make ourselves free from the influence of modes of nature or the external energy, from the influence of external energy of the world. So that's why in the beginning in this section, from 13th chapter, Lord says to Arjuna, oh my dear, and Arjuna said, oh my dear Krishna, I wish to know about Prakriti, nature, Purusha, the enjoyer, and fill up the knower of the field and knowledge and the object of knowledge. The Supreme Personality of God has said, this body, ocean of Kunti, is called the field. And one who knows this body is called the knower of the field. And like this, the 13th chapter is mainly described the soul and material nature, and there is also description of the super soul. And this chapter specifically, this 14th chapter, is a description how a conditioned soul get entangled with three modes of material nature, or how three modes of material nature just draw a conditioned soul, how it entangled. And also in the end of this chapter, the process is given how to overcome the influence of material nature. So in this is the first verse in this chapter, and Lord Himself, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Sri Krishna, is just glorifying wisdom. And he is telling that this chapter, the knowledge specifically in this chapter is the topmost knowledge. This knowledge given in the previous chapters is inferior to that knowledge is given in this particular chapter. Jnanam sanchinna sanshayam. One may have so many doubts, but when we know this knowledge, and the Lord is telling in many sages, in the previous year also, knowing who is, all the sages have attained this supreme perfection. So even we may practicing the process of devotional service, but still we must have knowledge. Without knowledge, we will be always in doubt in every circumstances of practicing bhakti. That's when there are many descriptions of knowledge or definitions of knowledge in previous chapters also. Jnana Sanchin, and in fourth chapter also, that is the Jnana Yoga, there is also Lord told about the importance of knowledge. Jathu idham si samadho agni bhasma sat kurti arjuna jnana agni sarva karmani bhasma sat kurti tatha. Just like there is a big amount of cottons, then in the mountain of cottons, but a simple one much stick is enough to just to make it ourselves. Similarly, one may have so many sinful, one may pass from many, many lifetimes. But jnana sankalpa, jathidham si samadho mi agni bhasmasat kunte arjuna jnanatmi sarva karmani bhasmasat. One is, when enlightened with divine knowledge, so that person can make himself free from the reaction of the sinful activity he has committed in previous lives or previously. So without knowledge, one always remains in illusion. He is always in doubt. What to do, what not to do. Krishna told, Sansayatma Vinasya. If a person always remains in such a situation, what to do and what not to do, he is not able to take any decision, then he is always confused. Such a person is subject to destruction. Sansayatma Vinasya, Krishna is telling. That's why even after speaking about bhakti, in the 12th chapter is known as bhakti yoga. But again, Lord is speaking about transcendental knowledge, concluding. Because without knowledge, the bhakti is simply sentimental. Must have knowledge. Why we are partnering certain things, we must have knowledge. Why we are authorized, you become niyamakara. If someone knows or did not know why he is doing something, then if he is not completely free from his doubts, then maybe in future he will need bhakti. So that's why you must know all these things. Knowledge means three things. You must know soul, super soul, and material nature, and the relation in between. And how the material nature is controlling a conditioned soul by three modes of material nature. How a conditioned soul will influence by this first nine verses of this section, this 14th chapter is describing about this. When a conditioned soul entangled with mode of ignorance, what happened to him? When he entangled with mode of passion, what will happen to him? And when by he entangled by mode of goodness, what is the end? So that's why we must have this knowledge. There is a general in this material world, this knowledge, the teacher also too, and those who are teaching material knowledge and some teaching. But practical in this age, now in this age, due to the Kali Yuga, the very rare teachers following the principles of Muni, following the parampara of Narada Muni. Just like you see that this teacher is Sukracharya and he disciples Sandhya and Amarka and there is another disciple Sarsitam from Narada Muni and Prahlad Maharaj. Now, everywhere we see those the people calling they are learning knowledge, but this is not knowledge. That's why this Bhakti Vinod Thakur composed the famous song. In one of his songs he wrote that Jada Vidya Jata Mayara Vaibhava Tumara Bhajani Vadha Anitya Sansare Moho Janmaya Jiva Kuru Karaye Gadha. Bhakti Vinod Thakur is telling Jada Vidya, this material knowledge that is we are getting through schools, colleges, universities. Mayara Vaibhava, this is the opulence of the illusory energy. This is a Tumara Bhajane Vadha, this simply touching a obstacles in path of your devotional service. Tumara Bhajane Vadha. Anitya Sansare Moho Janmaya, simply increases our attractions for sense enjoyment for this material world. Moho Janmaya Jiva Karaya Gadha, simply making us or teaching us the process how to work very hard, like an S. And so people are working so hard, they did not know why they are working. This is material nature, through material knowledge, the three modes of material, how this, the entangled conditions works. They did not know why they are working. Day and night, one is sweeter than honey, brighter than sunshine. So that's why the we have to know what is the real knowledge, what is the spiritual knowledge. That is especially in Adhyatma Vidya Vidyanam. I am the spiritual knowledge, I am all knowledge. So there is spiritual teachers. Now this all the material knowledge and material teachers. All school and college, universities, all what you are in this planet, they simply coming from the disciples of Sukracharya, Sandhava Martha, they know discussion of the soul research or anything about soul, material nature, or Supreme Lord, they know discussions, just like we are here. So that's why Prahlad Maharaj rejected the teachings of Sukracharya's ancestors, Sandhava Martha, and he accepted the teachings of Narada. So we are getting this knowledge also in this parampara from Sri Krishna Bhagavan, Sri Krishna Brahma and Narada, and in this parampara we are getting this knowledge from His Divine Grace, Abhayacharanaranda Bhaktivedanta Swami Sri Prabhupada. He gave His Bhaktivedanta purport, so we can understand very clearly what is knowledge. Knowledge means these three things. So we can understand who is the Supreme Lord in every page, just like today we read this verse, Vashri Bhagavan Vacha. And wherever there is Bhagavan Vacha, then Prabhupada wrote, Lord Sri Krishna says, the Supreme Lord Sri Krishna says. And there is one professor in Calcutta University, he was also like a great Sanskrit scholar, and he is little Mayavadi. And he came to Mayapur and he asked Prabhupada, he also wrote his Bhagavad Gita as it is. Sorry, he is just a Bhagavad Gita. He made his own commentary, word meaning, everything. And he used to come to Prabhupada. Swamiji, why your translations are not proper? Because I am a Sanskrit scholar professor, I could understand where you make errors. I have this Gita, you can see. There's many places they have written Bhagavan Vacha. Why are you writing? Sri Krishna says, Lord Sri Krishna says, why are you writing this? The Bhagavan Vacha, of course. Because they think Bhagavan is something impersonal. So Prabhupada told just to teach this Mayavadi. He told, okay, show me where I should go to turn good. Then he will show 100 places. He says, only Bhagavan Vacha, then you write in Sri Krishna. Lord Sri Krishna says, Lord Sri Krishna says, why are you writing like this? So in this way, Prabhupada by trick just engaged this Mayavadi to chanting and again, Lord's name. So, by reading this Bhagavad Gita with Bhakti Vedanta Purport, we can very easily understand who is the Supreme Lord. Lord Sri Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Then, we can understand also what is material, what is the soul, living entity. How living entity is part and parcel of Lord Sri Krishna. In forthcoming chapter, the next chapter, Krishna is telling in 15th, 7th verse. Mama Yivam Sa Jiva Loki Jiva Bhuta Sanatana. Mama Sastha Indriyani Prakruti Sanani Varsa Dhani. So our living entity is part and parcel of the Supreme Lord, or Super Soul. Then he is telling also material nature. How material nature acts, that is specifically described in this 14th chapter. There's three. Also in the 7th chapter in 14th verse, Krishna told, Daivi hesa guna mai mama maya yuraktaya maam ibaji prapadyanti maya metam tarantate. This is mama maya, this is my illusory energy. Especially this is my energy. Mama Maya, Durtaya is very difficult to overcome. It is not possible. Unless एक शटर अनलेस वन दर मम माया तुरते या नेक्स्ट टाइम दर साइकिल स्पेशली माँ में वो जो प्रपत जन्ते माया में था वन टाइम से प्रपत was giving class in Radha Nandaneswar and then he told in class but actually all this you are the audience here all you are listening to class this maya can entangle all of you you can be overcome by the illusory energy of the Lord but actually I am maya cannot do anything to me and I am free from maya maya cannot do any harm Abhinandan to his Prabhupada, your devotee. After class, Prabhupada was standing in front of the tea. Then he was praying something. Very soft ears and murmuring something. And his secretary was standing and hearing what Prabhupada is telling. And Prabhupada was praying very sincerely. Oh Lord, oh Radha Nandanesu, please. Please, you may always protect me from the influence of your illusory energy. Please, your illusory energy should not cover me, not protect me. Then he said, how is Prabhupada told just in class that this illusory energy cannot do anything to you? Now I heard that the secretary is telling me, I heard that you are praying. Why I am free from the influence of illusory energy? Because every day I am sincerely praying to the Lord, protect me from the influence of illusory energy. And if the devotees of ISKCON, we have this defect. The devotees of ISKCON, they do not fear Maya. They do not know Maya is so much powerful. Especially Mama Maya, Prabhupada. We pray every day to Krishna, to make only Krishna kind of work. And anyone who is under shelter of Krishna is every day. We are not forgetting to eating our prasadam timely, drinking water, but we are forgetting to pray to Krishna to make us free from the influence of illusions. So that's why in this chapter, the concluding verse of this is telling how we can overcome influence. Yoma abhyabhicharena bhakti yogena sevate sa gunan samatitaitam brahma bhayaya abhyabhicharini bhakti. To someone who abhyabhicharini bhakti, then he can overcome the influence. What is about abhyabhicharini bhakti? Abhyabhichara bhakti and abhyabhichara bhakti. Abhyabhichara means generally this word is used to Vyabhicharini. That means someone has considered so many people as his master, or a woman considered a mind with so many people. Same time he is thinking there are so many people as her husband. So this is Vyabhichara. And of Vyabhicharini means fixed your mind in one point. Consider only one person as your worshipable Lord. One person as husband. So this is abhyabhicharini. So Krishna is telling abhyabhicharini bhakti. In Bhagavad Gita, 18th chapter, 65th verse, this famous verse, Manmana Bhagavad Bhakto Madhya Jiman Namaskaro Mami Vishishitanti Patijane Piyoshimi. Prabhupada mentioned what is abhyabhicharini bhakti? One is to fix his mind only one Lord. These words stress that one should concentrate his mind upon Krishna. A very firm with two hands carrying a bluish boy with a beautiful face and pick up pillars in his hair. There are descriptions of Krishna found in Brahma Sangita and other literatures. One should fix his mind on this original form of the Godhead. Then Prabhupada is telling them, Lord has multi forms as Vishnu, Narayan, Rama, Varaha, etc. But a devotee should concentrate his mind on the form that was present before Arjuna. So this is of the Vicharini. Just concentrate our mind in one person. Even there Vishnu Kato, so many other forms, but we must meditate on one form. That is Ishvara Parama Krishna Sachidananda Vigraha Anadi Adi Govinda Sarvakarana. So in this way, this chapter is specifically teaching us what is the Abhyavicharya Bhakti and how to make ourselves free from the influence of modes of materialism. Uddhaka Chakti Samastha Padhyati Chayati Chakti Rajasa Jagarnya Gunat Vista Adho Vachati Tamasa. Those who are under the influence of a mood of goodness, the elements, the heavenly planets, demigods, all the siddhas, all these higher planetary systems, seven planets, Swarga, Janalok, Mahalok, Tapalok, Brahmalok, then Siddhavan, then. And those who are under the influence of Rajaguna, code of passion, specifically this earthly planet, specifically the people studying this human body. They having human body, they are mostly influenced by Buddha person. And those who are in lower species, then they are in Buddha influence. But bhakti, everyone is qualified to bhakti. But specifically those who have human body, they can start bhakti. Because there is so much opulence in the heavenly planets. So the demigods, they are thinking, sometimes we may get the opportunity to have a bath in this India, in this Bharatavarsha, so we can bath up, give us more service. And those are layers in India because of more, so much influence and mode of influence, they are also not able to bhakti. That's why Prahlad Maharaj instructed us. Omare Acharatpara, Dukuloha Mamsan Janma, Tadyati Adhruvam, Adhruvam. Omare Acharatpara, Dharma Bhagavatam Iha, Dukuloha Mamsan Janma, Tadyati Adhruvam, Adhruvam. This human life is very rarely achieved. And that's why Prahlad Maharaj advised, apart from devotional service, to start devotional service from the very beginning of our life. Kaumari, in the age of life, must start devotional service. At least, when we have been traveling in this 84 lakh species, we came to this human form, and whenever we get some knowledge due to mercy of the sadhus or sannyasi person, we must start devotional service. There is no other meaning to this human body. If someone has the human body and not performing devotional service, then his whole life is useless. Now, the stanza says, Manushya Janama Vadhiya Radhaya Krishna Navadhiya Janiya Suniya Pisar. Knowingly, thinking by his own. I have a human body, but I just lost my whole time without performing devotional service. So that's why we have to perform devotional service and must know who is the Supreme Lord and concentrate our mind at His lotus feet. So by His mercy, we can make free ourselves from the influence of material knowledge. Otherwise, necessary material nature, from the influence of the three modes of material nature. Unless the Lord Himself protect us, there is no question of by our own endeavor, we cannot make ourselves free from the influence of the material nature. Material nature is so powerful. Krishna is telling, Mama Maya, this is my real nature. unless they shelter of the Supreme Lord, then no question of getting out of tree from the influence of the tree. So that's why this chapter is very important to understand. This knowledge is from the second verse, the explanation start. In this chapter, the Supreme Personality of Godhead explains what those modes of nature are, how they are, how they bind, and how they give universe. In this potential chapter is description. Read after. The knowledge explained in this chapter is proclaimed by Supreme Lord to be superior to knowledge given so far in other chapters. Okay, any question answer? We can discuss more. Because this is just the starting of this plan. This is a general statement by the Supreme Lord. What is the, what you are going to discuss in forthcoming verses. And he is just briefly telling that the knowledge that we read in this chapter is superior to all other knowledge he has explained before. Okay, question and comments.
I thought it was rather interesting the problem. He ends this purport. He said, if one understands this chapter through the process of philosophical speculation, that's quite a statement, he will come to understand emotional service.
Yes.
So usually he uses philosophical speculation.
You don't know it, yes. Knowledge, this is this. Knowledge means there is a Sankhya, that is called knowledge. Sankhya means you have to know all the 24 elements, that is described by Lord of the how this everything is in this way. That is knowledge. You have to know five stotatos, then five, three, satu, bhumi, rapa, anurava, earth, water, ether, and air and fire, then mind. Mind, intelligence and possible, then five working senses and five knowledge acquiring senses, then five sense objects, like this is 15 and 8 is 23, then kala, time factor, and then soul and super soul, all together they have 26 elements. And knowledge means philosophical speculation, you have to discuss over all this. You have to know detail. That is what Prabhupada is explained specifically in Bhagavatam.
Guided speculation.
Huh?
Guided speculation.
You have to know everything. Sankhya, that is Sankhya philosophy. That is knowledge.
You explained about Avyapti Charani Bhakti, so in that you read of in 1865. So here it's written, the Lord has multi forms as Vishnu, Narayan, Ram, Varaha. And it's written, the Lord, but a devotee should concentrate his mind on the form that was present before Arjuna. So is it that even thinking of Ram and Narasimha or Narayan is inherent?
You have to go on that look at that particular planet. If you meditate on that path, then you have to go to that planet. God is, these are all free from birth and death, all the spiritual planets, but there is millions of Vishnu lokas. And any form you are meditating, you have to go to that form, that planet. Vrishikandra's planet is different from Krishna's planet. Mahaprabhu came specifically for this. Anarpita charinchaya karunaya vatanu. Samarpaitu unnata ujjvala rasam so bhakti siyam. Hari purana sundara padam vasandi pitam sadaa hudaye kandare spurata vahasachinam. Before all acharyas, they go, get the way how to go to spiritual planets, Vaikuntha planets. But no one can enter the Vaikuntha planet necessarily, into the world of Vrindavan, unless following the Radha Bhakti, following the prudence of the Vrajavasis. That is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's gift. Otherwise, by doing simple, I can go to some other spiritual planets also. One is so much attached to Nrisimha, that may go to Nrisimha planet. So now we are just worshipping Nrisimha there, just to destroy our obstacles in the path of Krishna. Our aim is not to go to Nrisimha. So, I am attracted to Nrisimha, then Nrisimha is everything for me. This is not our goal. Just to go to Nrisimha. Someone is attached to Rama, Ramachandra, he also go to Saket, Ayodhya. Even Krishna also passed times three places, Mathura, Dwarka and Vrindavan. So anyone attracted to one pastime, he has to go to both the other also. Krishna is spiritual world, Krishna is all three places. So as to Gopa Kumar, he is not satisfied in Dwarka, Mathura, he has to not be to him. So even we have to fix our mind. That's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu called Aradhya Bhagavan Vrajesatanaya Tad Dhama Vrindavanam Ramya Kachit Upasana Vrajavadhu Varghena Jatavadhyana Srimad Bhagavatam Pramanam Amaram Prema Kumartha Mahan Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Matamidam Tatra Varanatara. This is the goal of Pundi Vishnavas. The whole philosophy is given in this verse and by Vishnu Chakraparti. Who is our worship of Lord and what is the process to attain it? If our mind little here and there, we have something attraction to opulence of Krishna, then fix your mind. What a state of Nanda Nanda. Mahaprabhu, the name is so many names of Krishna, I only select two names, I accept only two names. Shyama Sundara, Jasodanandana, Dui Matrajana. Krishna Sabdara, Bahu Artha Namani. I don't accept so many meanings to the word, the meaning of the word Krishna. I accept only two meanings. I accept only two meanings. Jasodanandana, Shyama Sundara. I don't accept, I don't know who is Devaki Nandana. I only know only Jasodanandana. Jasodanandana, Shyama Sundara. And then Radharani called Tim Shyama Sundara. So this I know only. I don't know so many things. So you have to fix your mind in this way. Sadhak has to fix.
Just a small story. In 1984, I took my two-year-old daughter to Mayapur after the festival, thinking it would be more peaceful. There was a very huge dacoit attack, maybe 30 dacoits. To the temple, and I turned off all the lights upstairs. I was on the third floor, and then I went with my daughter under the bed and chanted probably the most sincere 45 minutes japa that I've ever chanted and probably will ever chant in my entire life. And I was chanting Hare Krishna very sincerely. When I got back to Bombay, some devotees were saying, why didn't you chant to Lord Nrisimhadev? So I said, well, Prabhupada trained us to chant Hare Krishna. And it just seems so natural to chant Hare Krishna, because that's what we're doing. This was the process given by Lord Chaitanya. Sure, if you want, you can go to Jhandajweep. You can go to Nrisimhadev.
And have Prabhupada gave the Nrisimha mantra in the Sanskrit Chaitanya as well.
That's there.
So when the black people threatened, they would attack here. Both other men. Brahma and Prabhu and our brothers, they are fighting with this. This Gundas and Prabhupada just stand on the Rathirada, the chariot, and he told, now I am giving you one mantra, if you rest to chant. Then even the old obstacles will go. Then Prabhupada chanted, Namaste, Varasimha. And all devotees chanted, and just they finished chanting this Namaste, Varasimha prayer. They immediately police then come and they just arrested all the black people. So now devotees can get all these devotees.
So, yeah.
Just to remember to see that just to destroy our obstacles in path of Krishna Bhakti. We don't want to him as our worshipable Lord to go his path. That is his form, that's Krishna's form to appear in that form to destroy our obstacles. Jatpada Pulla Vajvan Vindhaya Kundha Vandi Vanam Samaye Sahagana Adhiraja Vignan Vihintu Malakasya Jagat Prayasya Vindam Adhi Guru Santam Nandhya. You need to worship the Lord of Ganesh. This materialist, they don't know who is Krishna, who is Krishna. They are simply meditating on Ganesh, but Ganesh is meditating on Krishna, on Krishna. And getting his power to destroy all of the obstacles from Krishna.
He so beautifully described the difference between spiritual knowledge and material knowledge, and he said how it makes us an ass, only material knowledge. But at the same time, to survive in the world, you need both. So how much spiritual knowledge and how much material knowledge one should?
That's why when Yusuf is telling vidyamischa vidyamischa jo vyakti ubhayam sa. So he has to know about vidya and avidya, but intelligence will be given by how much you need. So my surrender to Krishna. Sapasya jaham vrishadni mishta mata smriti jnanam apoham mishta. So Krishna will give. When someone surrender, then Krishna is giving you what you need. Then king is surrendering. Someone is surrender. They're following the six principles of saragati. Then everything. They're given by Krishna. Then Krishna supply everything. That's why in Chaturswati in the 10th chapter, Krishna is telling in 11th verse that my devotees never do anything. Desam Yavanakam Bhavatam Ahamad Dhyana Jantam Nasayami Atmum Bhavasam Dhyana Jantam Nasayami. So one thing you have to say, Krishna will take care of.
You know the Sanskrit, I only know the concept, but I know that you said that in order to get out of material energy, you have to know what you're trying to get out of, so you have to learn something.
That is knowledge, that is Sankhya. That's a speculative knowledge. Philosophical speculation. Okay, any other
recommend or
question?
Hare Krishna.
Okay.
Hare Krishna. My question is not specifically related to this current verse. But it's regarding the mode of
material
nature. So under the mode of ignorance and other lower modes, the person, especially mode of passion, living entity in the mood of enjoying the senses. So under such conditions, then he has no interest in Shravanam, Kirtan, and Shraddha, he doesn't have Shraddha, Sadhu Sangha, Shravanam, Kirtan. So how should he guarantee that?
Yes, Prabhupada did in Western world practical. How will you do this? What is this symptom of a person having a mood of passion? You want to work hard. He cannot sit idle. He cannot sleep also. Just he wants to do something and he needs some praise, some name and fame. So Prabhupada engaged the power of the young people, take my book bags and go and distribute. And then we'll be nice, Prabhupada gave him very nice, and you are very nice. First. So then all the others would he get so much praise from Prabhupada, so we must also.
Generally he doesn't have interest in devotional service, that's all his devotional. That is all his devotional service, whether distributing books or chapter.
He had the intention to work hard.
Yeah, he so. Yeah, he wants to work hard and enjoy his senses.
So what is the question?
So my question is that how he can come to bhakti then? How can he do that?
By the causeless mercy of a devotee. Prabhupada told this, Western Lord, they told, okay, Prabhupada, by Bhakti Rasam Sindhu, we know that he obtained some part from some Sukruti in previous life, and he cannot start Bhakti in this life. So we may have performed some Sukrutis in previous lives. Prabhupada told, no, this is due to my causeless mercy only. So, that's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told, without mercy of a devotee, Chariya, Narottamdas Thakur told, Chariya Vishnu Seva. Is that a way to Mahaprabhu told, Krishna Bhakti Janma Mula Hai Sadhu Sangha. The root cause of Krishna Bhakti is associating with a pure devotee. And this is the main reason also for getting the love, getting the pure love to the stage of achieving the pure love of God. Krishna Bhakti Janma Mula Hai Sadhu Sangha, Krishna Prema Puja Hai, the new Mukhyam. Is the prime verse. We are thinking maybe Saddha in the past. Saddha, no, how can you get Saddha? As you said, there's a Mahaprabhu telling to Sanatana Muslim, first Sadhu Sangha. Then you get Saddha. Then you say, and then you search for spiritual master, then the second Sadhu Sangha, then you get the Bhakti Lata from spiritual master. So Sadhu Sangha is there. Sadhu-san, sarva-sastri-kai. Labhinatva sadhu-sangi sarva-sikai. By the causeless mercy of your devotee, like Narada Muni, he was just traveling and get Ikram Murgari in his course of traveling. So he did it. Prabhupada was traveling following the instruction of the spiritual master, so he saw this hippies there, the individual there. So in this way, without the mercy of spiritual, a pure devotee is not possible. Bhramite, bhramite, jadi sadhu vaidya paaye. Tara mantra vale maya pisachi paaye. Bhramite, bhramite, just in course of our traveling, somehow other we will get touch with a pure devotee. Then he will make us free from the influence of maya. By his causeless mercy.
Thank you.
Okay, do you have a question?
You say that very few teachers are there who are following the principles of Narada Muni. So I just want to request you to please explain in brief so that, I mean, what sort of principles a teacher should follow?
What principles you two teachers, Narada Muni is following, I told Prabhupada, he divine this Prabhupada is following, he is modern, Narada Muni for this modern age. So we are following Prabhupada, we are following Narada Muni. And all the present acharyas at the ISKCON, they are teaching us and following this parampara. What Prabhupada taught in his Bhakti Vedanta Thakur, that is teaching us of Narada Muni.
Okay? Thank you.
Right? Yes, last question.
I'm sorry, but I came in with you, but I want to understand what Prabhupada says. Prabhupada says that the knowledge given in this chapter is better than the knowledge given in all previous chapters. How is that? Because previous chapters contain knowledge of devotional service and everything.
So I told that's why devotional service without knowledge is sentiment. That's why after even describing devotional service after the 12th chapter, Krishna is giving divine instruction and knowledge. Otherwise, this is not. So we need to know what is, not devotee and not ignorant, of course. They know everything. How can you teach the devotional service? You must have transcendental knowledge. So that's it. After giving bhakti, describing bhakti 12th chapter, it's not describing. Then the transcendental knowledge. How to teach that? Hare Krishna.
Bhagavad Gita is it is
yes.
Srila Prabhupada.